to do with fruit boxes. So a grocer wants to sell fruit boxes. He wants to make the boxes from a square cardboard that's 36 inches by 36 inches. You can see the shaded areas, they're going to be cut out. It folds up and it makes the box you see on the right side. And then it gives some dimensions in terms of the corner, which is 4 inches by 4 inches, which helps with the flaps to understand the volume. So calculate the volume of a finished box. Show your work how you would calculate this volume. So from the diagram, I need to get length, I need to get width, and I need to get the height of the box by looking at the flat version of it. So that's the work I was kind of filling in numbers before. So I know the corners are 4 inches. So I got 4 inches, 4 inches, 4 inches, and I know the whole thing is 36 going down. So if this is 4, that means the other side is 4. The whole length is 36. So notice I went 36, take away 4, take away the other 4. What does that leave you with? 28 inches. Now what does this side represent when I look over here? And the answer is that side there represents the length of the box, which is 28. Then I need to find the other dimensions. So look at 4. What will 4 represent when you look at it? And I want you to notice that 4 and the width of it. So 4 is going to represent the height when you fold it up. But there's one more area I need to figure out, which is this width of the bottom of the box. Now notice I already gave you the answer here, 14. But how did I come up with 14? Is I took that 28, so notice I have 4 and 4 here, so I have 4 and another 4 here, and what's left over by doing the same math is 28, but I have to split that 28 in 2, so I divided 28 by 2, so that gives me each one on each side here is 14. So what does 14 give me? That 14 gives me the width. So how would I find the volume now that I know the length, the width, and the height? I just got to multiply them together. So 28 times 14 times 4. And that's it. So 28 times 14 times 4, that gives you a volume of 1,568 inches cubed. So you obviously, you can use your calculator for that. We're going to do Desmos on the second one. You'll need Desmos for the second one. So make sure you have that available. So turn the page for the second one. Now on the second page, we're taking those same fruit boxes, but suppose he starts with the same square of card, but he changes 4 inches to a different number. What is the largest volume he can make from the box? And then show your calculations. So I want you to remember how we found the volume before with 4. So with 4, I went 36 and I took away 8. By going 36 take away 8, I should actually hear it. Let me back up here so you can totally see it. Okay. So I took 36 and I took away 4 and I took away 4 again, and that was the length of it. Now the height of it was just, so that is the length. The height was 4, we'll get there. The width, remember what we did for the width? Is that we took that answer, which was 36 take away 4 take away 4, and we divided it by 2 to figure out the width, and then the height of it was just 4. So this was the length, this was the width, and this was the height. That's what we just did. But I want to change. So wherever there's a 4, I want to change it. I don't know what to change it to. It's a variable. It could vary, but I want to find the one answer that will give me the most capacity. So I'm going to change it to a variable. So instead of 4, I'm going to change it to x, because I don't know what it should be. So let me, wherever there's a 4, I'm going to change it to x. And then I'm going to simplify it in a moment. So for every 4, I put in x to change it to a variable to see what that B if I change the size of it. Now, if I simplify the first one, that's 36 take away 2x. So x and another x, that's subtract 2x. Here, you have 36 subtract 2x, but you're dividing by 2. But I can simplify that as well. 36 divided by 2 is 18, and then 2x divided by 2 just leaves me with 1x. So you have 18 subtract x, and then x by itself is perfect. I don't need to simplify it any more than that, but this would give me the volume of it. Now, I want you to look carefully. We know that x has to be bigger than 0, because you can't have a negative height for the box. But I also want you to know that the x cannot be bigger than 18. See, if the number is bigger than 18, now you have a negative dimension here. So all values are going to be between 0 and 18 that I'm looking for. All right, now it's your turn to go to Desmos. So I want you to go to Desmos, and I want you to type this in. Now, I would type it in as v at x. So if you use parentheses, v parentheses x equals in that box, type this whole thing in as you see it. And then once you've typed this whole thing in, what are you looking for after you type it in? So you're looking for the point that gives you the most volume. So the y coordinate is the volume. So what you're looking for is the highest point between 0 and 18. At 18, the answer is 0, and then it goes back up again after 18. But I don't want any answers greater than 18. I just want to look between 0 and 18. Now, when you type it in, you're going to have to zoom out a lot. Zoom out, and then scroll up. Zoom out, scroll up until you see the vertex point and click on it. So press pause and see on Desmos, can you find the x value that gives you the greatest volume on Desmos? All right, I'm going to try something that I haven't tried before. There's a button here that says record screen. I want to see if I can actually then go to Desmos and still talk. So if I said record screen, which it is, so we're recording the screen. Let's see if this works. I don't know. So can you see my Desmos right now? I'm going to see and go back later. Notice that the point I got here was 6 and 1728 as a point for the maximum point. So what does that mean? So that means that when x is equal to 6, that means the maximum volume is 1728 for that box. So the question was, what is the largest volume he can make? And the answer for the maximum volume is the y coordinate there. So it's 1728, and it'd be inches cubed when 6-inch squares are used. All right, let's see if I can go back to the other screen, or I don't know what I'm doing. So we'll see if this works or doesn't work. So if I go back to the other screen, where are we at? I don't know if it worked or not. Oh, we'll see. All right, Mr. GMath, over and out. So there you go. What's the maximum volume? 1728 if you had 6-inch squares compared to the volume of the other one, which was 1568. All right, Mr. GMath, over out. Till next time, good job doing your work.